Hey guys, Andrew here, and I'm playing Destroy All Humans. So, yeah, this is for the original Xbox, by the way, like Xbox, old Xbox. I don't know, I played this game as a kid growing up. I really enjoyed it. I think it was one of my favorite games. Not like the best game, but just like a fun game I had because as a kid, I just like killing people, I guess. I don't know, problems. But yeah, let's go ahead and get started here.
Hello, friends. Have you ever gazed up into the night sky and wondered at the possibility of life on other planets? What marvelous beings might exist out there, hands extended in friendship, awaiting the moment when we humans take our first tentative steps into space? What tales will be told of that glorious day when we are first contacted by our brothers from beyond the stars?
Five. All systems go, General. Four.
Come on, baby, show us what you got.
Three.
What the hell?
Two.
What in the blue blazes is that?
One.
No, wait! Stop the countdown!
I should never have sent you.
What's shaking, Pox? You look a little, what's the word? Constipated.
Let's just say I hope you turn out to be less of an evolutionary dead end than your predecessor.
You lost me.
Shall I tell you a secret? Few of our people know this. But the DNA patterns in our cloning banks are becoming more and more degraded with each new clone.
That's bad, right?
Only if we want to retain our immortality through cloning. Of course it's bad! I sent Crypto 136 in search of a planet we visited many eons ago. A planet seeded with pure Furon DNA. But I lost contact.
Let me get this straight. You sent me, him... Crypto 136 to a hostile planet, and he's disappeared. Maybe captured. Maybe even being tortured as we speak.
Well, I wouldn't jump to any conclusion.
I bet you wouldn't. Let me tell you something, Pox. You're a smart cookie. But there's a time for thought, and there's a time for action. And this is one of those times.
Which?
The second one.
Perhaps you're right, 137.
Of course I'm right. You kidding me? A Cryptosporidium captured by a bunch of monkeys? We gotta go in. We gotta crack some craniums. We gotta rescue me. Him. He's gotta rescue me. I mean, I gotta... Brains, man. When do I get to blow things up?
Patience, Crypto. Patience. I take your point. Prepare the mothership.
That's what I'm talking about. So, what's the name of this crummy planet?
Our destination. The planet Earth.
All right. Hey, guys. Welcome back. So, as you can see, there's a lot of stuff going on in that cutscene. One of them is, you could noticeably tell who those voice actors are because this is back in the day before they actually were famous voice actors and, doing side gigs to try to get their name out there. So first of all, I'm going to go ahead and try to put on subtitles, which is really important. Unfortunately, you can't actually get to this menu until after that cutscene, so it's kind of obnoxious. But yeah, so I just wanted to go ahead and do that. Let me save the game real quick. Yes. And another thing too is, what's really cool is that the game is heavy on nonsense. As you can tell, there's just a lot of silly crap that makes no sense, and it doesn't need to make sense because it's a silly game.
Welcome to my little laboratory. You may not have known this, but I flatter myself to be something of an inventor. In my spare time, I've been developing some truly impressive weapon and ability upgrades. I'd be happy to share them with you. If you've got something for me in trade, say some of that delicious DNA you've collected. Did you want a saucer upgrade? Or something a little more personal?
I don't have any DNA. Sorry, Fox. See you later. Let's go ahead and let's see. Okay, so those are the... So there's some videos. It looks like there's two cryptos I have. All right. Let's go ahead to the hangar and let's go do a mission. So, Turnipseed Farm. All right, invade it. And I'm off. So one of the cool things about Destroy All Humans, at least I think, is that not only do they try to play themselves as a B-movie, but because it's clearly what B-movies were like, but it also has some pretty interesting, fun little jokes here and there, like clever writing, pretty good gameplay mechanics, actually. I don't think as far as I can remember, it's going to be a while. I'm going to relearn how to play this game pretty quickly. But from what I can remember, the game actually had some pretty easy-to-use mechanics and controls. And the writing and story was pretty memorable, as in being kind of funny and well done. The only problem was that unfortunately they didn't make a sequel, like three sequels to this game, and the other two sequels were just not good.
Orthopox to Cryptosporidium 137. Come in, Cryptosporidium.
Crypto here. How's the view from the safety of the mothership?
Very funny. Let's just say I'm glad I'm up here and you're down there. Loathsome little planet. Now, Crypto, to ensure this invasion runs smoothly, it is imperative we identify the dominant life forms on this world. Those lactating bovoids are likely candidates.
Surely you don't mean those foul-smelling gas bags beyond the fence?
Yes, I'm afraid I do.
But they're covered in nipples.
Now, Cryptosporidium!
So I am to try to designate who exactly the best life form or the top life form is on this planet. It's clearly not chickens, because chickens are dumb, but it might be cows. So let's see, Cortex scan. Target a cow and pull and hold the left trigger, then scan the ability. All right. We can peer into the minds of lower life forms via the Moo. Okay. Primitive, yet profound. Okay. Two moos. Don't think that there's much thought going on here.
They eat with their mouths. Ugh, I think I'm going to be violently ill. Attention, Earth creature. This planet is now part of the Furon Empire. Your benevolent masters welcome you. At this time, we wish to abduct you for the purpose of scientific research. The procedure will be protracted and invasive. Do you have any objections? Earth creature, I am addressing you. Respond or be vaporized. I don't care how many stomachs you have. I don't have time for this.
Psychokinesis. Well, let's see. Targeting a cow and pulling, calling one. All right, so I can lift a cow into the air. Shaboom! That cow is dead. Let's see. So I can bring it closer to me, and then I can throw it at other cows. Oh! Got Concentration. Using the mental abilities drains concentration. The concentration meter is at the top left of the screen. Okay, recharges over time. Oh, shit. So, do I have full concentration? Oh, God, that cow's gone. Oh, okay. Well, that didn't go exactly as I planned, but, you know. Whatever. Bam! Killed all the cows.
Martha, you didn't tell me we was having barbecue for dinner? Wait a minute, that ain't steak. That's... Holy Mother... Martha, give me the shotgun!
The Zap-O-Matic. Pull and hold R to fire the Zap-O-Matic. Firing the Zap-O-Matic drains the batteries. Wait for them to recharge before firing again. All right. Oh, brain extraction. Okay, L trigger and extract. Oh, I got DNA. And his head blew up.
Harold, come on back. You gotta see this. They got a talking horse on the TV. I ain't never seen nothing like... Ah! Little green spaceman!
Ah! I am not green.
Crypto shields. Crypto is protected from damage by a shield. The shield energy bar is shown at the top right. Oh, okay, with everything else. Evading combat for a short period of time will give the shield time to recharge. If the shield is depleted, Crypto becomes vulnerable to death. Oh, that sucks. What should I be afraid of? Oh, more farmers. Let's go ahead and get some brains here then. Boop. Ah, oh, brains! Come back! Ah, oh, yes, sweet, sweet brains. So you can see their heads explode, and then their brains are left, and that is where the DNA is stored. With the DNA, I can use it to get upgrades and all sorts of other good stuff. Also, apparently there are a lot of copy-paste farmers on this farm. But, that's okay, that's exactly how the flyover states work, right? It's just all the same cowboys in the same overalls.
Evening, Ms. Turnipseed. We got a call from Farmer Dixon over the other side of the state road. Said he heard some pretty strange noises coming from over this way.
What is that? A new silo?
Crypto! That human law enforcement officer is attempting an unauthorized entry of your spacecraft. If those pea-brains were to get their hands on your quantum deconstructor, they could rip a hole in the space-time continuum! Boo the Furonity!
Oh, yeah, please don't touch my stuff. I don't appreciate that. Oh, I can chain it. That's kind of cool, actually. Whoa.
Oh, yeah? What you doing?
It's also another good way to kill people, is to pick them up. If you're dealing with... Because if you're dealing with too many people at one time, it's sometimes helpful to just pick up everybody and throw them away. Because, you know, I don't know, it's kind of convenient to be able to just... What? Wait. He has nothing in his brain? Oh. I need to wait for my thing to recharge. It's really hard to notice, Wow, they require a lot. Cops require a lot of brain power to do that. But, yeah, so that bar on the top left is actually my energy bar, but it's really hard to tell that it's running out because it's kind of like the same color as the bar, which is really weird. So let's go ahead and get in our saucer and get out of here. We'll see. One of the cool things about this game is... The kind of time period it wants to take its place in. It wants to take a place in like the 50s, 60s kind of area. So it's kind of neat that there's, it doesn't, you know, it doesn't have like stupid, crazy technology. Just, brah, fuck this house! Death ray, pull and hold the right trigger. I've been doing that to fire a death ray for long periods. Cause it overheat, but it will quickly cool down when you're not in use. Alright. Okay, that house is gone. Do 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 do. Oh, that's a nice little patio outside you got. I see it's somebody running away. Burnt to a crisp. Get your stupid silos out of here. There we go. Ah, fuck farms. Oh god, that was quick. Army just like deployed and got here that fast.
Move out, man. Move.
I don't know, but I've been told Joe McCarthy's good at
Oh, great. The human military industrial complex. We can't allow them to alert their leaders to our presence. Exterminate them. Now!
Open fire!
Whoa. Let's get that tank out of here first off. That tank is like the only threat to me. Saucer's hull. When the saucers take damage, the hull integrity is reduced. Hull integrity bar is shown at the right top as the top right. The only way for it to repair the hull is to find a repair pod. Pods drops in. Pox drops him in when you destroy certain buildings. Okay, cool. Ow. Whoa, what? Brought another tank in? My god, these tanks. How can they withstand death rays so well? I don't know, 50s technology was so good. Okay, who else is shooting at me? It's kind of hard to control the camera. Oh, fuck. It's kind of hard to control the camera in this game. Oh, jeez. Okay, hull's taking too much damage right now. Ah, fuck. What the hell? Pox, are you going to drop a fucking hull thing or what? Oh, he tried to... That was like predictive shooting. That's an impressive AI. I didn't see any of the pods, but maybe they're like in a building behind me. I'm not like 12, so I'm not bad at playing games.
Did you see what I saw?
You bet your sweet ass I did. What did you see?
Little green man in a flying saucer wiping out the best infantry unit in the US Army.
Right, good. Me too. Green? Not gray?
Don't be a stiff. You know what it means?
Absolutely. What?
It means the papers got it right for once. Get on the horn to Silhouette. We've got the worst case scenario.
The eggheads were actually onto something? I don't believe it.
Believe it. Roswell was only the beginning. The invasion is on.
Mission complete. Thank you. And so at the end of every episode, you get a nice little newspaper clipping from what appears to be like paranoia and misinformation. So cattle mutilation pandemic, farmer disappears amidst cow abuse allegations. DNA harvesting. You will need to land the saucer to harvest DNA. Once on the ground, you can gather more DNA by extracting brain stems. Completing side missions and collecting Furon probes. You will be notified when you have collected enough DNA to unlock the next mission. Great. So let me land the stupid saucer. You can only land it in those like circled area, the crop circle looking areas. So, a good tip for those of you who might not ever play this game in your life, because why would you? But, and I'm out. Alright, so let's see here. Anal probe. Press X button to cycle to the anal probe. Pull the right trigger to fire the anal probe, giving the target a mild probe. This causes them to grab their buttocks and run for the hills. Pull and hold the right trigger to charge up the anal probe. The pure shock of this super probe will cause the target's head to explode. What? There we go. Fuck it. We're doing the Zap-O-Matic. Which is a lot easier. Anal probe is actually good for when you want like a lot of DNA. Because doing the extract like this only gives you 10, but doing through the brain probe actually gives you 25. So it's kind of advantageous to do that. And soldiers take a lot more hits than women do, but your range isn't all that great on this, so you gotta be... Fuck. You gotta be really good about aiming, and I'm not, because it's been a while since I last played a Xbox game. Let's see. Can I find a person anytime? Like, holding this trigger is not really feeling too good. There's a guy. You look like you need a butt plug. Plink. Oh god. There we go. Splink. Thanks for the brain. I need what? 250 DNA? Oh god. No, no, not in the water. No. No. I did not mean to go in there. You've been killed. No, I've drowned. Apparently, they're keeping with the War of the Worlds thing. Fish boy pulled from the lake. Fish boy fried up, halted. Fish boy fried up, halted by arrival of government officials. God damn it. Alright, so the new clone's here now. So every time you die, you actually play as a new clone of Crypto, which is kind of a cool little thing. But it's kind of unfortunate because there are a lot of things that can kill you, like water. Water is one of the things that can kill you. So let's go ahead and try to actually gather enough stupid brain stems. Let's see here. You can do abduction beams. And drop them. abduction beams are kind of neat for if you're trying to... when you're trying to pick up, like... when you're trying to pick up, like, objects, like cars or tanks, later on you can upgrade your ship to actually pick up heavier objects, which is really, really useful when you run into situations like, oh god, I should probably worry about, like, six tanks right now. Maybe I should just pick one up and chuck it in the water. Like, that kind of stuff. Yeah, that kind of stuff. Alright, let's find a farmer. Let's see here. There's one. Hold your buttocks! Aw, oh, you son of a bitch! Oh, jeez. It's really hard to aim this, and I don't appreciate how hard it is to aim. I don't know, I really hate how difficult some like aiming in old school games are. Just because I'm accustomed to auto aiming, which is not a thing we had yet. They call me in the war. Chapoomp, right out your butthole. Alright. Hey girl, how's it going? You can run, but you can't hide from Crypto and his butt beam. Haja, girl. 50? Damn. Alright, 50 DNA. Or might be in it for the long run, but how about we do this? Jabam! Oh, this game's running a little bit weird right now, but I guess that's pretty normal on an Xbox. Can't expect the game to run perfectly. Yeah, I am actually playing on an old school Xbox, by the way, in case you're wondering. So, I'm not, like, emulating this game in any regard. I am actually sitting here and doing the tedious, let's see, I wish to test your observation skills. Crypto, race to the locations I tell you as quickly as you can. Travel to each checkpoint as quickly as possible. Time limit 2 minutes. Alright. Chicken coop. Shit. It came from outer space. Farmhouse? Oh, man, come on. Isn't farmhouse, like, all the way over here? Oh, wait, this is farmhouse, right? Never mind. I was like, I thought I was talking about the barn for a second. Oh god. Okay. The jetty? What the hell is a jetty? That sounds dumb. Grain silo. I've got time. Might as well get some DNA out of it. Boing! Alright. Alien coming through! Gotta do a thing. The old dead tree? Where the fuck? Oh, okay. Whoa, guys, please. Just trying to get some DNA here, alright? Come on. No need to be saucy about this. Blue Moon Cinnamon Billboard. Oh, god. Oh, jeez. Almost fell in the water. Ah, shortcut. Didn't think I'd take that, huh? So, yeah. Doing side missions is actually really good to do. Oh, I got a probe. Collecting all the probes is actually good to do, too, but they're really hard. Oh, shit. Finish line? Oh, god. I'm racing over there. I'm getting there. I'm gonna get it. I'm out of it. Okay, so in case you're wondering, on the back of the jetpack, there's three little bars, and that signifies how much, like, jetpack you got. Hey, 175 DNA. Boom, baby, look at that. Oh, God. Hey, girl, I heard you're looking for some anal probes. Brown. Ooh, 10 DNA. Mmm, girl, you got it going on. Oh, what's this bonus mission? I'm gonna do this, I apologize if it's boring to watch this, but the reason I'm doing these ahead of time now is so I don't have to go back and actually waste my time doing them, and it gives you some kind of idea of some of the little mini games and little things you can do. So never forget our primary mission, Crypto, collect DNA from human brain stems. I have a quota to meet. Collect 4 brain stems. Well, this is actually the easiest fucking mission. Shablam! Open your buttocks! Alright, that's 2 brain stem. That's gonna be 3. I'm gonna go ahead and get this probe real quick. Yoink. Yeah, there are a certain amount of probes in every area, which kind of blows if you want to do, like, the completionist route. Not so bad if you don't care about it at all. Just point that out. But, yeah, I need to get 1 more brainstem. So let's go ahead and get this guy's brainstem. What'd you say to me? Fool! Open your head! Boom, baby. Done. Yeah, 158. Those brain stems should be more than sufficient for my research and testing purposes. Oh, science. Whoa. Oh, I thought I got the chicken there for a second. I was like, oh, God, no. I'm sorry, chicken. I didn't mean to give you an anal probe. So you can see I'm actually getting a lot of DNA now. So it's kind of nice because now I'm going to have... Basically, I have 1,000 DNA is what I'm going for right now. If I can get myself to 1,000 DNA, I'm pretty set on some basic upgrades and what's it called? Whoa, everybody dance! Oh God, you guys are still alive? Okay. Yeah, if I get about 1,000 DNA, I'm pretty set on the next map and some actual upgrades that I need. Because this game does have a difficulty curve that starts rising real quick if you don't start upgrading fast enough. So, let's go ahead and head over to my ship. Oh, wait, there's one more minigame I'm gonna do here. Because I think that's it, right? Yeah, there's only 3 in this area. So let's do the last minigame. Had enough of this cursed town. Destroy all the buildings, leave no trace. Alright. Oh, gotta run over to my ship. And this is the best one. I don't know. I personally loved doing the Armageddon ones, which is like, just get rid of all the goddamn buildings and don't even care anymore. They're stupid, humans are stupid, shut up humans, you smell bad. But yeah, so basically you just have to go through and destroy all buildings, which is, you don't think about it, but there's a lot of like things that count as buildings. A lot of weird things that you don't think would count as buildings either. But let's go ahead and destroy that. That town's gone. Get out of here, stupid, whatever you are. Wheat storage or something? I don't care. Goodbye. Let's get this. You don't need boats, stupid. It's just a lake. It's not like there's fish in there. It's man-made, stupid. Here's a house. Fuck houses. Why do you have one house on all this land? You should pay better property taxes. You shouldn't be able to afford this. I can't even afford a house that big. All right, fuck you too. I hate you. I take out my poor grievances on you people. You guys suck. Let's keep going down this way. Oh, I just burn these fields. Fuck fields. I hate fields. What's over here? Oh, there's another landing spot. Where else are buildings? It's kind of hard because... Oh, duh, I can just check my mini-map. It's kind of hard because you can't, like, view any other... There's, like, no other views you can go to. There's, like, this is it. This is the view you have. So it's kind of a pain in the ass. Oh, minute 30. Oh, God, I may not be able to make it all the way over here. Just destroy your shitty house. Army shooting at me. There's like a... I'm at the invasion side. I'm just trying to avoid being shot down by that thing. By anti-aircraft guns. Oh God, there's a thing over here. Oh, Jesus. They are like literally shooting anti-aircraft missiles at me. I didn't even know the 50s had anti-aircraft missiles. What? Do you even have fucking jets? When did you get jets? Stop! God. A missile is a danger to myself and others. My God, what if this ship crashed? You would have a giant ship crash on your hands. You I'm in the fucking invasion site. Oh god, everything's getting bad. Okay, my hull's getting a little bit damaged. One last house right here. Fuck your barn. Burn it down. Okay. 33 seconds. I only got two more buildings, though. This house. Shut up. I'm in the invasion area. Shut up. I got it. Just fuck your house, man. Fuck your house. Yes, 200 DNA. Woo. And I think that's every mini game. So I'm ready. Let's go ahead and can we head back to the mothership. Return to mothership. I'm pretty sure, man. I think I got enough DNA. I'm out of here. Deuces. Ooh, my ship is in disrepair. All right. New mission available.
Now then, I know what you're thinking. What can I, a lowly novice, do to help bring about the destruction of Earth and the inevitable reign of the Furon Empire? Well, I'll tell you. It was in the earliest days of the Empire we realized our species was doomed. Eons of waging war on inferior races with unregulated atomic weaponry had mutated our genes. We could not propagate due to our complete and utter lack of genitalia. Fortunately, a Furon ship happened upon Earth on its way back from destroying the Martians. Human society was young and nubile. Sailors on a foreign planet, letting off steam, one thing led to another. Long story short, every human being alive today has buried deep in his genetic code a strand of Furon DNA. Over the eons, we've learned to clone ourselves, but with each iteration, the information degrades, and the results are increasingly unpredictable. The Furon genes in humanity's DNA are ancient, uncorrupted. They represent the future of the Furon race. If only we can get at them.
Well, good thing I got a bunch of them. Let's go to Pox's lab and see what I can put in them. Ooh, what can I put in them? Let's check myself. Let's upgrade. Oh, wait, I have like no upgrades. Oh, wait. So I can't get better at psychokinesis. Can I get better at my ship? Okay. Step right up. Weapons, abilities, offer. You have nothing. You suck, Pox. You suck. Alright, so because Pox is kind of a jerk hole and doesn't have anything to give us, let's go ahead and call it an episode. Alright, so thanks for watching. See you guys next time.